Welcome to another sing-along time for families with Powell River United Church. I'm really happy to see you and thank you for spending this time with me. We're going to start today with a song that we did last time. I thought it might be fun to do it again, partly because I really like this song and sometimes it's nice to have the same song at the start, like a gathering song. So I was thinking maybe we'll use this one at the start of each video for the next few weeks. It's called To Be Alive. And when I used to sing this when I was a teenager, we always started with that statement, to be alive, and then we started singing the song. So I'm gonna try that. Not sure if I can get my voice in the right place to just start out like that, but I'll try it. To be that song are so true, hey? How great it is to be alive. Now, here's a song that's kind of fun. It's an old 50s tune. Now, I'm not much of a rock and roll guitar player, but I'm gonna try. This song is called Johnny Be Good, okay? To the chorus are sure easy, hey? Go, 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 Johnny, go. Okay, I hope you're singing along with me. Here we go for the rest of the story. He used to carry his guitar in a gunny sack, sit beneath the trees by the railroad tracks, sitting there passing the time of day, strumming to the rhythm that the drivers made. People passing by, they would smile and say, oh my, that little country boy can play. Go, 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 Johnny, go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go, nice job singing that song. That song, I think, was popular when my mom and dad were teenagers. Okay. Let's see what we're going to do this song, what key we're going to sing it in. This song is called Give Me Oil in My Lamp. Okay. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning. Give me oil in my lamp, I pray. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning. Keep me burning till the break of day. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. For you. Put my guitar down. You might have been listening to some other videos when we had some other stories out of this book called Unlikely Friendships. It's a book written by Jennifer Holland, and this is all about animals who have become friends with each other, and they're animals that you wouldn't expect to be friends. So that's why it's unlikely friendships. So today I thought we could look at a story about a macaque, which is a kind of a monkey, and a kitten. Isn't that cute to see that monkey holding the kitten? Let's hear about these two. There's a sacred forest in the town of Ubud on the Indonesian island of Bali, where monkeys roam freely over the stones of a Hindu temple built centuries ago. The primates are long-tailed macaques, and many local villagers believe they guard the religious site against evil spirits. One macaque recently brought its protective instinct to a more secular task, safeguarding a scrappy kitten that had strayed into arm's reach. With more than 300 macaques in four separate troops living in a relatively small area, it's not surprising that they occasionally meet other animals pawing across the temple grounds. But to form a bond like the one that this particular macaque formed with this particular kitten seemed extraordinary to the people who witnessed it. Anne Young, who was on vacation and visiting the sacred monkey forest during the time, was one of these witnesses. And she said, the pair had been together a few days, and whenever the park staff tried to capture the kitten, it would just run back to the monkey. The macaque, a young male, would groom his feline friend, hug and nuzzle it, and even lay his head on the kitten's head as if it were a pillow. Although this species of monkey is quite social and often lives without fear in close contact with people, this one wanted to keep his pet kitty to himself. He became wary of all the other primates around him, and if other macaques or people got too close, he would try to hide his prize, once even using a bit of leaf to cover it, or climb higher, or move deeper into the forest with the kitten in his arms. The kitten, meanwhile, had plenty of opportunities to escape the macaque's clutches, but it made no attempt whatsoever, Anne says. It seemed content to be carried around in the bigger animal's embrace. Long-tailed macaques live in a strict social hierarchy in which males must prove themselves worthy of female attention, and this troop was no exception. The kitten petting male was not an alpha male or leader among his own kind, and was probably not getting a lot of affection from the other monkeys. And he certainly wasn't getting much affection from humans either, as macaques have become something of a nuisance in U-Bud, where they wander into rice fields or villages outside of the forest boundaries and wreak havoc on private property. Sounds like the deer in our community, hey? The deer roam around everywhere in town and eat all of our flowers and stuff. The kitten appeared to be traveling solo as well, and may also have been craving some attention and companionship. Fortunately for both unmated primate and homeless feline, they found what they needed in each other among the temple ruins in U-Bud. And here's another picture of them snuggling. Very cute, hey? I like those stories because they remind me that all of us can be friends, you know, even if we're different kinds of people. Okay, I think that's what God would like for our world, hey? For all of us to be friends. So let's close with a fun song. We have sung it before on videos, so you might know it. It's called Over My Head, and it's from our hymn book that's called More Voices. Okay, over my head I hear music in the air. Over my head I hear music in the air. Over my head I hear music in the air. Over my head I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere. When the storms of life are raging, I hear music in the air. thank you so much for joining me today. I really had fun with you, and I look forward to seeing you next time. So take good care and have fun, and bye for now.